Solve the system by substitution. X minus 3y equals negative 5, and 2x plus 12y equals negative 4. So to solve a system of equations, we are looking for that xy pair that makes both of these equations true. And to solve a system by substitution, we're going to take one of the equations and isolate just one of the variables. And I know that usually we are used to isolating the y, but we're going to do something a little different in this one. But we'll isolate just one of the variables. Okay, isolate one variable. So which of these equations looks like it might be easiest to isolate one of the variables? It looks like this first one would be the easiest, and it looks like x would be the one that would be easiest to isolate. Sometimes in the systems it's going to be easier to isolate the y, but in this particular example we'll isolate this x. To do that, to get x by itself, let's add the opposite of the negative 3y on each side, so plus 3y, and then I'll just put a line over here and let's rewrite that problem as x equals 3y minus 5. And I'm going to put parentheses around this just to denote that that whole expression is what we will be plugging into the other equation. So the process is to isolate one of the variables, or solve for one of the variables in one of the equations, and then once you have that expression that equals the variable, take that expression and plug it in for that variable in the other equation. So let's rewrite this second equation two times. I'm going to leave out the x, not leave it out, but I'm going to leave a space there, plus the 12y equals negative 4. And now again, I'm plugging in that 3y minus 5, so I'll just use the same color just to drive this home of what we're doing there. Okay, now let's distribute the two, and because we have two times that entire expression, and what you're left with is 6y minus 10 plus 12y equals negative 4. Let's combine like terms and you get 18y minus 10 equals negative 4. Add 10 to each side and you get 18y equals positive 6. Just to show that, we added 10 to each side. And then let's divide by the coefficient to get y by itself. And then we get a value of y where y equals 1/3. Okay, we've got half of this problem done. We have the y value that will be part of the solution to this system of equations. Now that we have the y value, we can take this y value and plug it into y in either equation, either one. Again, the first one looks easier. We could plug 1/3 into y in the second equation and it would be fine, but let's plug it into the first one just because it looks easier, and there's nothing wrong with taking the faster route there. So let's go with this purple color and say x minus 3 times, I'm going to put this in orange, that is the y value, 1/3, that's what we're plugging in, is that y value, equals negative 5. Okay, so now we've got to solve this equation for x. X minus 1, 3 times negative 3 times 1/3 is negative 1, equals negative 5. Add 1 to each side and you get x equals negative 4. So we have our x and y values, and just at the end, it's a very good idea to write your answer all in one nice, tidy place. So negative 4 is the x value, and 1/3 is the y value for the solution of this system of equations.